Hello, this is Angela Anderson. Thanks for joining me tonight. We are going to be painting a very simple beginner landscape. We are going to be doing this desert poppies floral landscape here. I think it should be really easy. You can change the colors. If you don't like orange, you could do red poppies or whatever color you wanted to. But I've got my husband Mark here with me.
Hey there, everybody.
He's going to be manning the chat for us. So if you've got questions for me while I'm painting, you can type those in all caps, and he will get those to me as soon as I'm able to have a break. We're going to try to get this done in about an hour tonight. I think it'll be pretty easy, very good first-time painting. I'm going to try to make it as simple as possible. So we've got a sponsor tonight. Our sponsor tonight is Skillshare. They are an online learning community with more than 15,000 classes in design, photo, and more. Everyone can take a class, try a project, even teach a class themselves. Premium membership begins around $10 a month for unlimited access to learning. You can get a 2-month free trial by clicking the link in the description and using the promo code AngelaArt. So let's get started today. I'm going to set that aside and put our little image in the corner. How are you doing tonight, honey?
So far, so good.
Very good.
I've had a piece of chocolate.
Oh, well, that's always a good thing.
Yes. I might have more.
Is that your dinner for now?
Yes. I'm on rations.
Okay. Sounds good.
But they're good rations.
Good rations. All right.
Okay, here we go with the colors.
Here's the colors. Titanium white, unbleached titanium, which is a mixture of white and yellow oxide, maybe a little bit of brown. It's a Liquitex color if you're looking for it. Titan buff is the golden version. This is yellow oxide. Cadmium yellow light, cadmium yellow medium, cadmium orange, cadmium red light, quinacridone magenta, phthalo blue green shade, dioxazine purple, which can be mixed with these two colors, so you don't have to have that if you don't have it, and burnt sienna. So that's our color palette. Should be pretty easy. Really, any colors, like I said, would work. Mainly, you're going to want if you're going to change your colors, so say I wanted to do red instead, you're going to want a red that's kind of a middle red, and then a red that's sort of orange for your highlights, and a red that's sort of purple for your shadows. So, and that goes for all your colors. So like a warm color for your highlights and a cool color for your shadows. So if you change these colors, just keep that in mind. So let's go ahead and do the sky. Our horizon line is going to be right about at the third mark. So if you just kind of figure out with your fingers, make a little mark there and just do a line across. Doesn't have to be perfect because our hills are going to kind of roll into the grasses or the poppies. So if you wanted to, you could tape that off though, if you want it exactly straight. I'm going to grab a little bit of the blue. The phthalo blue is a very, very strong color, so you just need a teeny tiny bit on the corner of your brush mixed in with this white, and it'll make a nice bright blue. And then I think I want to pick up just a little tiny bit of purple and put a little bit of that in that sky color too. Grab a little bit more of that phthalo, a little bit more of the purple. So I've got kind of two colors to work with here. I'm going to put that darker kind of purpley blue up at the top, and I'm just going to use a large flat brush. You could use large sponge brush, that's the word I'm looking for, sorry. If you don't have a nice big flat brush, just grab yourself a dollar sponge brush. You can do the same thing with that. It doesn't have to be expensive for this. And as I get down toward the horizon line, behind our mountains are going to kind of go in this area. I'm going to add some blue, and I'm just going to kind of wisp it up. You can see in our picture that the clouds are kind of wisping up in this direction, so I'm just going to kind of pull some white from my horizon line at a diagonal up in this direction.
So how many Q-tips would you have to tape together to make a large brush? Just wondering.
I'm not sure.
I buy them 500 at a time, so.
You probably, I would say, oh, I don't know how many, maybe.
How many 30? That is? About that many?
About that many, about an inch round.
Oh.
What you made me do.
What did you just do?
I just ruined it. It's done now. No. You can just wipe that off with a wet towel.
But we actually have a real art question here.
Okay.
Let me see if I can find it again.
I'm going to try to streak just a few. I'm just using the edge of the brush now and just streak a few little streaks of white in that direction. And that's all we're going to have to do, really, for the sky. I might go back in here and add just a little bit more of the darker thalo. So I'm noticing that there's a little bit of a lot of white going on. So while it's wet, I'm just going to get a little bit more of that brighter blue up in there.
You ready for the real
wipe
art question?
Off. Yep.
Let's okay.
Grab some more white.
Real
go
question.
Here we go.
Is.
Yes, what?
If the person does not have CAD orange.
Yes.
What is the best way to make some?
It's not completely mixable because it's got a vivid tone to it, but I think if you used your cadmium yellow and some CAD red or CAD red light plus CAD yellow, you could get something pretty similar. So those are the two I would use. Okay, there we go. So we've got that kind of wispy thing. I'm not going to do it exactly like the picture. We're just going to try to keep it simple. So I'm going to go ahead and clean that out. And while that is drying, I'm going to go ahead and put in kind of the background for our poppies. And that will be quinacridone and a little bit of the cadmium red light. And I'm going to use a little bit of this yellow oxide just to tone it down a little bit. The yellow oxide's a little bit more brown, so it'll kind of tone down that oranginess. And I might even pick up just a little bit of purple. There we go. Let's put that in here. And we're going to be doing a little bit dark underneath the orange because you need a little bit of contrast when you're doing this. If you don't have contrast, you won't be able to see the brightness of your colors. So having a little darker color underneath will help. Now as we get down toward the bottom, I'm going to mix a little bit of green. Let's use the thalo and thalo blue and yellow oxide. Grab a little bit of burnt sienna. We'll do that down here. And then I'm just going to kind of mix them together in the middle where they meet. Now the green and the red are opposite on the color wheel, so they will kind of turn a muddy brown, but that's okay because that's kind of our dirt color anyways, so it's not going to matter too much. Here I can grab a little bit more of the thalo or the yellow oxide to help that transition out. This is just our undercoat. Most of this is going to be covered up. But we're just trying to get a good first coat on here. It's going on pretty. All right, let me grab a little bit more of that green right here.
We've had Lindsay just join us.
Lindsay! Hi, Lindsay! How are you? Lindsay was witness to my biggest debacle yet on YouTube. We did our castle collab. Here's our castle painting that we did. I did on Friday, and me and Cinnamon and Lindsay all went back to back live on Friday, and then I got to my parents' house in Branson and deleted my video on accident. I was putting our paintings in my playlist, my collaboration playlist, and I accidentally deleted it. I cannot believe I did that. And poor Mark's going to have to hear about it for the rest of his life because I'm never going to live that down. Oh, my goodness. Yeah. So That happened.
Yes, the look on your face when you did it.
Oh, I know. All thought somebody had died or something.
Yeah, she just sat on the couch with her head in her hands, not saying a word. And we're like, what? What?
So, oh, it was bad. It was so bad. All right, I'm mixing phthalo, or burnt sienna and purple here. I'm going to make this kind of the background for my mountains, and I'm going to add some white to tone it down a little bit. Makes a lovely burgundy kind of color. And we're going to do this back here on our mountains. I'll grab a little bit more blue too. Add a little bit of blue into that. I feel like they need to be a little bit more blue. There we go. So you just look at your picture, kind of refer to your picture. These mountains are pretty flat, so you can kind of just have fun with it and sort of wiggle a little bit. Just do some random shapes. Doesn't have to follow your picture exactly. They're pretty low, though. They stay pretty low to the horizon. Or you can make them taller if you want to. It's your painting. Okay. My brush is not wanting to stick together. It's kind of flaring out on me. I might add a little bit of glazing medium. That might help.
I was just going to say that.
You were just going to say glazing medium would help me?
Exactly.
That's what you were thinking.
Yep.
Got it. Thank you, honey.
Or some kind of medium.
Okay. There we go. Well, I want to keep this straight right here, if you can. And I might just go ahead and tape it off when we get to the orange part.
You could use your sweet new T-square you got.
I know. I did get a new T-square. And it came in the biggest box available. I was like, I don't think it was that big.
It's only, what, 18 inches?
Yeah, it's 18 inches. It came
and
in like
the box was at least box. 3 feet long. It was like, what did we order?
Oh, my gosh. I'm going to add a little phthalo blue in here. It's going to look really weird at this point. It's a, you know, ugly stage right now. All the background is usually, anytime you're laying in your foundation of your painting, it's going to look weird. So just got to kind of trust the process. If this is your first time painting, just realize that this is normal for it to look a little bit off. And, oops, uh-oh, I touched water on there. That's not good. I'm going to have a little bit white. Well, it was dry. Yeah. See if I can put it back in there. All right, I'm going to have you dry that for me, hon. You didn't know you were going to have to dry it today. So if you have a hair dryer handy, that probably is a good thing to use. Just don't get it too hot on the acrylics because they can, I don't know. They won't bubble, but they'll get kind of, sometimes the top layer will dry, especially if you've got a thick paint. Top layer will dry and then the bottom layer won't. So just kind of dry it quick, slowly. About 12 inches away from your painting so that it doesn't get too hot too fast. So, and I guess while we're waiting here, we can go ahead and do our stick man guy. We'll give him some poppies. How about that? He can have some poppies in his underneath. This is our mascot, stick man. Mark drew him, and we add something to him for every show, depending on what we're painting that day. So we'll have some poppies here. Here's a little lamb. He never did get his castle because we ran out of time. So Mark says that it was this Revenge of Stickman is the reason the castle got deleted. So there could be some truth to that. I don't know. And there's Stick Cat on this one too. So he's got, it's actually kind of coming along pretty nicely this time. He doesn't have any, you know, weird shoes or shell bra or anything.
The edges are kind of.
Okay. All right. Stickman 2. That was Stickman 3.0. Stickman number 2 ended up with high heels at the beach.
Right. Now, technically, that's Stickman 3.1.
3.1, okay. Got it.
Get it right.
Sorry. All right, so this is dry. Very good. Okay, so now I'm just going to put a few little highlights on my mountain here. And I'm going to use my, mix up a little bit more of that green. Because I kind of run out here. I'm going to pick up a little bit of the phthalo blue and yellow, cadmium yellow medium. Makes this really bright green, so we don't want it quite that bright. So I'm going to grab a little bit of the burnt sienna and mix that in with it and see what that does. Kind of tone it down a little bit, make it a little bit more brown-ish, a little more neutral. That'll work. And I'm going to grab a little bit of my yellow oxide too and mix like a little version of it with some yellow oxide over here. Grab a little bit of blending medium. And a tiny bit of my unbleached titanium. And we're going to do this right along this line here, right at the base of our mountain. So we're just going to lay in some horizontal lines using about a half inch brush here. And I'm just going to do a few in my red section here, just a few. We don't need a lot of this color back here. Most of this is going to be orange. If you look at our picture, it's almost solid orange back here, but there are a little few sections of green, so we want to put those in. And I'm putting them in a horizontal motion. That'll kind of give you the illusion of depth. The sections farther away from you will be very, very thin, so the sections of green will be really thin way up here by the horizon line, almost straight next to each other. And then as you get down toward the bottom, they're going to get larger and farther apart and a little bit brighter in color too. So we can put a little bit of our brighter greens down in here. And I'm going to leave lots of my background showing still. I'm just going to fill in a few little sections with this greens, leaving gaps for our puppies. And I'm not using a lot of paint, if you notice, so you don't need a lot of paint to get this effect. Grab a little bit more of that yellow. Most of this middle section is green. I'm just going to tap, maybe create a second color with a little bit more of the lighter green. Tap a little bit of that in there.
Can you try not breathing while you're not talking?
Try not breathing when I'm not talking? Why am I breathing too much in my mic?
In your mic, yeah.
I'm like, sorry, like, did we get too close to my mouth tonight? Just looking straight down at my thing here. I'll try.
Okay.
I'm not sure if that's possible.
I'll revive you if that doesn't work.
Okay.
Or I might just take over myself and finish out the painting.
I would like to see that, actually.
I'm not sure our sponsor would.
No. Yes. Speaking of sponsors, thank you to Skillshare for sponsoring our video tonight. Very nice of them. Okay. Purple, burnt sienna, and a little bit of the unbleached titanium here. Makes this kind of a, soft purple color, and I'm going to use my brush sort of flat, and I'm just going to drag some highlights in. Might need a little bit more light color there. A little bit more of the light. There we go. Let's just drag a little bit of highlights on here. Using the brush kind of flatly like this, holding it at an angle, will allow us to kind of skim it along this one side and pull some highlights in the mountains. Don't use a lot of paint. We're dry brushing here, so you don't have a lot of paint on my brush. See, I barely have any paint. It's not really globbed on there thick. It's just... Here we go.
So we have a viewer mm-hmm. in here. It says they're 16 years old and just starting to paint.
Okay.
And they want to know if you have any advice for beginners.
Yeah, I do, actually. I mean, the tutorials on YouTube are a really great way to start. I think one of the things that will help you is have good reference photos always. So if you're trying to do your own painting, you know, from a photograph, just make sure that you've got, you know, good reference photos. If you're doing it from the tutorials that are available on YouTube, use the traceables. Don't feel like you have to draw. If drawing's not a skill that you already have, and you're still working on it, don't feel, you know, like you can't use a traceable. I think that learning to paint and learning to draw are two different skills. So if you're just wanting to learn to paint and don't have the drawing skills for that yet, I'm going to grab some of this green that was my far green, add that a little bit to the purple color. There we go. We'll use a little bit of this right back in here, right at the base of those mountains. Buy good brushes. So if you're going to invest in anything, get good brushes. Take good care of them. Clean them every single time you use them. Don't let them sit in your water too long while you're painting, and don't wait till the next day to clean them out. Don't leave them laying around with paint on them. And practice. Give yourself permission to make some messy paintings until you get the hang of it, and that's normal. And I would suggest getting a practice pad, like my favorite is my Strathmore pad. It handles a little bit differently than canvas, so it won't, let me see if I find my more recent paintings here. I'll find the tulips that we did the other night. There's the tulips we did for my bonus Patreon folks. But this paper is mixed media paper. It's nice and thick. It holds acrylic paint really well. You don't have to do anything to it. You can paint straight onto it. You do have to add a little bit extra water to your paint because it'll dry it out a little bit more quickly. But it's great to practice on because each of these sheets is, you know, pennies. And so you don't have to worry about ruining a whole canvas if you're just practicing, you know. So grab something like that, practice a couple of times, and then put it on canvas, So... She probably got way more information there than she wanted, but.
Well, do you recommend her quit school and just take up painting full?
Yeah, no.
No?
No.
So
no.
Stay in school?
Stay in school. Practice as much as you can in your free time.
Okay. Yeah. All right.
And get a set of paints, you know, like an acrylic set, like the Liquitex Basics or something like that, that's got, you know, multiple colors in the set, and then you can buy the bigger bottles and the better acrylics later. But I would definitely get yourself, you know, a nice set of decent brushes. So, okay, now I'm going to start putting in the orange. So we're going to grab this cadmium orange here, and I'm going to mix it with my quinacridone magenta for my far poppies back here underneath this orange that we made, or this kind of a reddish color that we made. And I'm going to just tap in horizontal lines. I'm going to actually pick up some of this unbleached titanium and lighten that up a little bit too. Tap in, holding my brush steady. I've pushed it to a flat point, so I've got a good chiseled edge on it. And I'm just going to hold it upright and just tap my horizontal lines in along that far section. Load it up fairly thick with paint this time. you want it to come off your brush pretty easily. So and by tapping instead of pulling, you can get kind of that texture of the flowers too. And there's some. And I'm going to kind of try to avoid some of the green spaces. Go around those if I have some nice green spots. So I don't want to cover those up completely. So go around those a little bit. Let me zoom in so you can see it better. It'll be fine. It's not focusing. Huh. I know, but it's not focusing. All right. Okay. Still doesn't. Yeah, I guess that's better. All right. This looks a little bit light. So, and you want to leave a little bit of that background color showing too. So another thing that we can do is use a fan brush. I'll show you how that would work. If you have a fan brush, you can use that color and tap with it, and it'll even get more texture than that that other brush was doing. Keep on going all the way down here. I'm going to grab some of my cadmium red light and start putting in a little bit of that in too. Just a few little bright spots. It's a little bit darker orange. Just take your time with it. Don't rush this process. The tendency is to want to, you know, just do like that and get it all done in one, you know, 10-minute little setting. But if you take your time, just kind of tap, 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 do multiple layers of these colors, you really get a neat effect. So just got to be a little bit patient with the process. And I'm grabbing the straight cadmium yellow or cadmium orange now, and I'm going to tap a few spots of that in there, just in places. See how that's just going to give it a little bit of highlight here and there. I'm going to keep most of that really warm color down toward the bottom though, but I do want a little bit of that darker color in the back sections. And as I get down toward the bottom here, I'm going to grab a little bit more of my mixture of the quinacridone magenta with this cad red. Tap in some larger, and I'm going to pull just slightly down this time so that I'm making bigger little sections of paint. Before I was just tapping straight up and down, now I'm going to kind of pull just slightly so that my sections of flowers look like they're a little bit thicker, whiter maybe. Now I've got all this green in here. There's actually a lot of individual clusters in this green area, so we'll start kind of setting aside a few spots to put in some little individual clusters and leave some space in the green. Like this. Try to keep it random. And I'm trying to keep it pretty horizontal too. That's kind of the key with these landscapes, is you kind of want to keep that horizontal aspect. It helps give that illusion of distance. So okay, now as I get down towards here, I'm gonna turn my brush and stab at the corner maybe. Might even switch brushes. Because I want smaller, more individual flowers coming closer to us. There's still some clusters, but you're seeing some individual flowers starting to, at least. Okay, and then I'm going to leave this bottom section for now because we're going to do some really large flowers down here. But I do have a few little. Let me grab the orange now. I'll wipe most of that darker color off my fan brush. You don't want to wet your fan brush while you're working with it because it'll make it a little bit soggy and the bristles will get floppy. So keep it dry. This is one of the brushes that you can kind of abuse a little bit. You wouldn't want to do that with a normal softer hair brush, but these hog hair bristles can take a lot of abuse. Okay, so let's start putting in some highlights in some of these clusters that we've got here. I'm just setting my brush down and kind of wiggling it a little bit. Going over the top, leaving the darker underneath. So that it looks like maybe there's a shadow there. Putting this brighter color on top. Clean that out and dry it really well. I'm going to grab some of our green. I might need to mix some more. It's getting dry. Let me spray my palette down with a little bit of water. Grab that phthalo blue, cad yellow medium, a little bit of burnt sienna. Okay. And then we'll grab a little bit of the quinacridone magenta to soften that color up a little bit. I'm gonna, I want it a little bit darker than that. Okay, let's mix up a little bit of this burnt umber and, or burnt sienna and quinacridone. Sorry, I'm saying these colors wrong. Burnt sienna and phthalo blue.
I know you're driving me crazy over here.
Am I?
Yes, I was like, come on, say the right colors.
Okay, I'm gonna pick up a little bit both, so I have a little bit of both colors on my brush there. And I'm gonna, there we go. Just gonna pull in some random grasses. Just a few little dark areas and maybe target some underneath some of these poppy clusters so that there looks like there's some dark shadows underneath some of them. You don't have to do all of them, but just a few will help. Do that. And then as I get down here, I'm going to really pull some longer grasses. most of this will be, well, some of it will show. So now I'm going to grab a little bit more of my yellow. Let's grab some yellow oxide, actually. Mix that in. We'll do some little clusters of that color. This will break up these lines. So if you've got some really dark areas there that look too noticeable, like you can see the brush stroke, you just kind of want to go over them slightly with this kind of medium or a green, and it'll tone them down a little bit and sort of knock it back into the painting, make it look like it's part of the landscape instead of just sitting on top. So I'm just kind of targeting some of these areas like this and sort of pulling up over the top of the bottom of it so that it's sort of hidden a little bit. Okay, that's good, I think. Now we're just going to put a few little of our brighter poppies in and we'll be done. So I'm going to grab my number 4 round. This is where you could use a Q-tip if you wanted to, honey.
Right.
So it's a possibility. But
I guess we should actually say cotton swab.
True, yes.
Because I think that other is a brand name.
It is a brand name. Yes, and it's probably not in all the parts of the world either.
Right.
So, cotton swab, yes. All right, so I'm going to create some like V-shaped flowers. They're going to be kind of in this shape. So just, and these ones in front here are kind of actually quite large. So do them like this, and then we're using this darker color just to kind of lay the foundation of where we want to place them. They're really close together. They're clustered together in our picture. But I'm going to separate them just a little bit more so that I have a little bit more control over the way they look. And don't get too caught up in making every single one a perfect cone. You can just kind of put some dots out for a few of them. Some of that glazing medium just to kind of make the paint a little bit more viscous. Excuse me. Sorry. Why, I was breathing into my mic again?
Kind of sounds like you're out in the wind.
Oh, okay. All right. Well, maybe we'll get a different mic soon, and don't. It's one of the things we want to look into getting. But I was watching a video. I was watching our Paris video the other day, the one with the Eiffel Tower. And I'm telling you, we've come a long way since that one, because we couldn't even hear you. You were not on mic yet, so you were just kind of random voice in the background, and I was answering your questions, but you couldn't hear what you'd asked me. So it was not ideal.
Yes, we have made some improvements in the sound department.
Definitely.
And our next step is for cameras.
Yes, yes.
For all the Patreon supporters have been awesome,
they
incredible.
Have been. Yep, we're going to able. Made our goal last month, so we were able to have enough. We're still researching cameras yet. There's too many choices out there, but we're definitely narrowing it down, so that should be within the next few months. Okay, so notice how I kind of tried to keep it random. There's no repeated patterns. And I did sort of clustered, you know, like there's a cluster, there's a cluster, there's a cluster. These kind of grow in little clumps, seems like. Let me do one more right here. I noticed there's... All right, so now let's add our brighter orange. Actually, I'm just going to clean that out because I want nice bright orange for our highlights. And whoop. I'm just going to pull in just a few little spots. Just the light's hitting the top of the flower, but it's still dark underneath here. So if you notice, there's like a little shadow under a lot of these, and there's like an area of light right up toward the top. So that's what I'm going to try to replicate. Do this kind of highlights that sort of skim the top of the flower and leave some shadow underneath. And we're not, like I said, we're not going to paint in every single flower and every single part of it. This is sort of an impressionist type painting, so we're just getting the feel of it, the general color. But you don't have to, we're not going for ultra realism here, so you don't have to like worry about painting each individual petal of each individual flower. Just trying to catch where the light's hitting in our photograph so that it looks generally the same without having to put all the little details in.
I'm glad I took my allergy medicine.
Why?
With all those flowers.
I didn't warn you, did I?
No, but I'm prepared.
You're prepared. Good. I'm going to put a few of these dots over the top of this transition area between the faraway flowers and the nearer ones, too. Just a few very small dabs. That'll kind of help visually transition between these two sections. Maybe a few random dots here and there. Amazing how little dots can make look like a flower. I don't know. It's your eye kind of fills in the details. You give it the setting and the right colors and your eye's like, oh, those are flowers. Even if it's just a dot. It's pretty cool. Really, they do look like dots if you're far enough away, so. This would be the same technique if we were doing poppies, darker poppies, like red poppies. We would just be using probably this cadmium red light for this instead of this orange here. And we would be using a medium, probably this quinacridone magenta with some red underneath or something. So, and I have several poppy videos, so if you want to kind of see the colors that I used in those, you could use those in this one very easily. Okay. All right, now we're going to grab our cadmium yellow light. This is a really bright, almost neon yellow. I'm going to use it to dab in a few little random yellow flowers. If you look at our photograph, there's actually some little yellow flowers in here. So I'm just going to use that to kind of indicate those. Might even grab some of the medium cad and add a little bit of that to those too. Cad yellow medium. Put some up over the top of some of the poppies too. Just a few. Just got a fly landing on my canvas here. I don't know how it got in my studio. weird.
See, it thinks it's flowers.
It pulled the fly. That's awesome. Love it. I love that. Yeah, we'd like to thank the our sponsors, Skillshare, one more time. They actually went to their website today and checked it out. There's really cool stuff there. And if you have a skill that you're kind of an expert in, some sort of technology or, you know, Photoshop or
drawing stick man.
Drawing stick man. You can get on there and do yourself a video and post it and get paid. So pretty cool. You don't have to just go to... All right. Just adding a little bit of yellow too, back to some of these farther back sections. Yeah, there was a lot of different topics. All right. I think... What do you think? Pretty good. I'm going to splatter some white. I feel like...
If I was a fly, I'd land on that.
Oh, gosh. I don't know why I even asked you these things. Okay, I'm going to take my paper towel, and sort of actually just turn this over and protect this upper part here. So I don't want to get it in the sky, but I'm going to just... splatter just a little bit of white down in some of these areas, and I just wet down some white paint in my fan brush here. There we go. If you get too much in one area, you can just tap it off. Helps if your background's dry though, so don't do it if your background's wet, because you'll lift off your paint. But I think that's good. I'm going to call it good for tonight. That was a short one, 48 minutes. We did good.
Man, that is awesome.
Yep.
Good job, honey.
Zoom out, huh? You can see the whole thing.
And you even got Stickman in early.
I did. I know. We did good tonight. We're on it. I must be hungry or something. So I want to say one last thing for our sponsor there. If you are interested in checking out their website, the link is down in the description. You can use the code AngelaArt to get a 2-month free trial.
Angela2?
No, you click on the link. It takes you to their website, and you use the code AngelaArt to get the 2-month free preview. So
excellent.
Yep. Thanks, guys. We really appreciate you. Please give a thumbs up, leave a comment, and we will see you on Saturday for I don't know what. I think we're going to, I don't know, we'll do another spring type painting. I'm in the mood for some spring art, so we'll do something fun, hopefully. We'll see you next time. Thanks.